everybody, welcome to a new sandbox.
Everyone,
so nice to see you all with your cameras turned on. Get comfortable, adjust your settings, enjoy the music that we're playing. If you want to adjust the volume of that, you can do it locally on your computer using the menu at the bottom of your screen. And while you get settled in, you can share in the chat where you're joining from, just to see where what places of the earth we have covered today. And then we can get started. I'm joining you from Cluj-Napoca, Romania, where autumn is coming in. It's settling in slowly but steadily. We have Hamburg, we have Southwest London, Lugano, Vancouver, UK, nice. India as well, Brazil. Catarina will post it from the other side of that. And Barcelona, awesome. Awesome. Thank you for sharing. Beautiful. Keep them coming. If you're if there are other people who also want to share, feel free to do that. I'm going to also start a quick flashcard, and if you want, please stamp on the scale that you see on your screen how familiar you are with Butter as a tool, as a video conferencing tool. Is this your first time using the app, or are you an expert user? Oh, all right. So we have people with various degrees of exposure here, but we also have some newbies. And more UK, I see in the chat, awesome. India and UK, amazing. So because we have some new people, some people who are new to Butter, I'm also going to give you a quick rundown of how to navigate the tool with ease. All the buttons that you're going to need are on the left side panel of your screen. You can say hi with an emoji. You can react throughout the whole session, let us know how you feel. If you have a question or a comment, you can use the Q button for that, so that we know to give you the mic and pass over a conversation to you, just like Chet guys and Zaytun now. Fantastic. You can say hello in the chat and use the chat throughout our session for messages and, you know, getting in touch with us and interacting with us. You can also take notes in Butter. You can have private notes or shared notes. If you want, you can access them after the session. And for unmuting yourself, you can also press the key button on your keyboard or unmute yourselves using the press button on that side menu that you have on your dashboard. And press the V key to turn on and off your video camera. Let me see. Is everything clear? Do you have any questions? Are you ready to move forward? Fantastic. Everything looks good then. Amazing. Amazing. So if we have that covered now, let me just introduce myself. My name is Andrea. I'm a coach and trainer and a core team member of the Butter community, where I run the Sandbox initiative together with Matija Samad and Cesca Teresa, who is here with us today. Say hello to the camera. And as you probably know, the Sandbox gives us the chance to play around with different ideas and tools and learn from each other in order to get feedback on our facilitation skills from fellow community members. And these events are recorded so that we can make learning accessible to as many people as possible. And our amazing host for today is Catarina. She's a Brazilian designer and the CEO of Adverso Lab, a branding and innovation consultancy that has supported over 200 organizations to achieve impactful results and innovative brand strategies. Since 2018, she has also been working in the intersection of branding and social innovation through various initiatives, being a facilitator, speaker, and mentor in various acceleration programs focused on social impact businesses as well. So, Catarina, I can't wait to see what you have in store for us today. I pass the mic over to you. Enjoy the session, everybody.
Thank you, Andrea. Hi, everyone. How you doing? Nice to see some familiar faces here. Hi, Brian. Hi, Sylvia. I guess we have encountered other times in other better facilitation sandboxes. So I'm very excited to be hosting this session today. I'm going to start with an icebreaker. Andrea already introduced me. but first, let me introduce myself. I'm a brand designer and also social innovator. I have a social consultancy, which is called Adverso Lab. We have a lot of projects with NGOs and also big companies working to create social impact. But today I'm going to speak to you about brand personality, which is a theme I like very much. So we're going to start with a quick icebreaker so we can introduce ourselves to this theme of brand personality. So I'm going to ask you, can you please choose in the poll which one of these brands resonates the most with your personality? So if you can choose one of these, if you don't have any, choose the one that is closest. So we have Lego, IKEA, Disney, Red Bull, Tiffany & Co., IBM. Very well-known brands. Okay, we have two people left. Nobody wants to be IBM. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, a lot of Legos here. That's awesome. That makes sense. And Disney as well.
And Disney, yeah. It's a draw.
Awesome. Oh, okay, it's a tie. Awesome. So next, what of this brand's personality traits do you share? Do you have in common? So if you can answer me. Okay, I guess the poll's closed. Something's weird. Andrea, can you help me?
No, it's more, it's open. It's just that facility.
It's open?
Can't answer the polls.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Cheska. So do you share any of these brands' personality traits? Which one of them? Any attributes you share? A quality, a value?
Oh, sorry, guys. Let me let's try that one more time. That might be a technical difficulty on our end. So sorry. Let's see.
Oh, okay.
Everyone now. See it now?
No,
it's perfect.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry, Catarina. Then it's our bad. Not.
No, that's fine. Okay. I guess people who chose minimalist are not Disney, right? Probably IKEA. Playful. It's awesome. Creative. Nice. So, who already answered? Can you guess which one of these personality traits are from which brand? Does anyone want to guess one of these personality traits, which brand they belong to? No, you're shy. That's fine. Okay, I guess creative can be both. Lego or Disney, right? Okay, minimalism, IKEA, playful, creative. Awesome. Adventurous, which one of this? Who answered adventurous? Can you tell us what is your brand?
Well, I was Red Bull though.
Red Bull? Okay, that makes sense. Bravery, Awesome. Thank you, guys. Just a quick introduction to the theme so we can all relate to what is a brand personality. So I'm going to be closing the poll now. And we're going to start a very quick presentation. So today we're going to be working with brand personality. I'm going to be hosting the session, but who am I? why I'm talking to you guys? I have already introduced myself. Firstly, but I am a designer, facilitator, and innovation consultant. I work with branding processes a lot. I usually host a lot of workshops, and I do have a new framework that I've been trying to test out. So you're going to be my lab rat today, if you're willing to. So I'm going to ask you to excuse myself because there can be some things a little weird, some errors, but that's fine because we are testing out a new framework today, which is called Brand Personality Accelerator. And I'm very excited to share this with you guys. And before we enter the framework, I'm going to tell you some little things about branding personality. So each brand has its personality, such as ourselves, right? Some people have multiple personalities, but usually we have one and we adapt ourselves into the situation, the context. The same is with brands. Brands are not that fixed. They are alive, right? They transform themselves, they grow, and we're going to be reflecting on this stuff a little today. And if you are not familiar with brand personality concept, it's very easy to see how it works because we have these two brands with the same product. Coke lovers are going to fight me because I'm saying they have the same product, but it's very similar, but they do share the product, but they don't share the personality. They don't share brand positioning, right? So which one of those do you relate most to? I see a lot of people choosing Coke, Coca-Cola. Some Pepsi fans, okay. They communicate very differently, right? Do you remember any Pepsi ads or Coca-Cola ads? They are very different. The product itself is different, but the personality is the main thing. So having a distinct personality can help a brand to be more memorable and establish a unique position in the market because we have these two competitors here, which are very similar, but they position themselves very differently. And Kendall Jenner, Pepsi, right, man, that's it. We have all of those pop divas in Pepsi, and we have Santa Claus in Coca-Cola, more loving, familiar, and the other one is more bold and edgy and pop culture, but it can also assist in creating communication guidelines. So if you are creating a new brand, if you are redesigning a brand, having a clear structure of brand personality can help us to create a tone of voice, can help us to guide visual assets, all sort of this stuff. So working with this, I have encountered three very easy and main steps into identifying a brand personality. I always like to say that brand personalities cannot be created. They are identified, right? Because we are born with our personality and the brand is the same. So we're going to be using this three-step framework today, which is called, named the Brand Personality Accelerator. In three easy steps, we're going to be firstly humanizing the brand. So finding personality traits that this brand share with ourselves. But today we're going to be exemplifying this using TV characters, movie characters, book characters, anything you like. So we're going to be finding some of them and encountering which personality traits they have in common with one particular brand that I'm going to tell you in a minute, which is, but you are all familiar with this brand, so be relaxed. And then the second step will be extracting attributes. We're going to be translating these personality traits into brand attributes, which is a more strategic side to it. So I'm going to be showing you the difference in a minute. And last but not least, we're going to be creating these communication guidelines using brand personality. Okay? All good? Awesome. So I have a challenge for you guys. So if you're going to be my lab rats, you're not going to come out without harm of this. So we're going to be creating today, not creating, but identifying Butter's brand personality. Do you all know Butter brand? This brand you're familiar right now? Awesome. So we're going to be identifying this brand personality. And there are no right or wrong answers. We'll be dividing you into groups, into breakout rooms. You'll be working together to find this brand personality. And smooth like butter. Yeah, super clever. that makes sense. And we'll be using Mural, which is a collaborative whiteboard. So if anyone has not tried Mural yet, that's fine. You can ask for help. So please stamp your choice if you have used Butter. Yes or no, so we can take a look. Okay, some people have not used yet. That's fine. If you need any help, just call us out, Chesco or Andrea or myself. You'll be divided into breakout rooms. Andrea, feel free to say.
No, I wanted to give you a thumbs up, but I pressed the Q button, sorry.
Okay, that's fine.
Familiar I am with Butter, right?
Okay, you will find a mural board in each of your breakout rooms. So when you enter the breakout, a mural will come out to you immediately. It can take a few minutes to open. It's not as smooth as Butter, but it will open eventually. And we're going to see an example of how it works. So if you want to, you can click this button here, and it will open a mirror example. But if you don't, that's fine, because I'll be showing in the slides here. We'll be using Butter King as an example, so I can show you how the framework works. So the first thing is we have a challenge. So we're going to be identifying Butter King brand personality as an example. And the first step is to humanize the brand. So if we think about Butter King, which characters come to your mind? To mind is Ron from Parks and Recreation, Deadpool, the Genie, Tyrion Lannister, Daffy Duck, all of those characters who are very witty, confident, funny, energetic. And this is what we're going to do for Butter. So which characters remind you of Butter? And we'll be using Mural, so feel free to add post-its or images. And we'll be doing the same as I did to Butter King, to Butter. Okay? Everyone got it? All right? Awesome. So if you need to add an image to Mural, you can click on the left toolbar, which has an icon of images, and you can add a GIF or a photo to it. And you can search for the character you're looking for. And then the second step, we're going to be extracting attributes. So previously, we have chosen these characters and reflected on what character traits they share with Butter. And then we're going to translate it to branding attributes. So brand attributes are the fundamental qualities or values that represent the core expression of a brand. So for example, for Burger King, boldness, focus on flavor, casuality, authenticity, you're going to be doing the same, but for Butter. So we use Butter as a case study. And then the last step is going to be applying to guidelines. So we're going to be taking all of those personality traits and all of those brand attributes we have created before and establishing communication guidelines. So we're going to be reflecting on three questions. In what manner will the brand communicate? This stands for verbal communication, tone of voice. In how will the brand behave, and how they will relate to the users, and how will the brand present that visually. So for example, for Burger King, bold and simple, attention-grabbing imagery. It is a playfully competitive brand, so we're going to be reflecting on those for Butter. There are no right or wrong answers, okay? We'll not be testing how accurate these answers are. The idea is to experiment with this framework, okay? That's fine? Awesome. If you have any questions, please let me know. So let's do this. It's a very hands-on session. So I'll be dividing you into your breakout rooms. You'll be getting your mural boards, and you can complete this framework. We'll be entering the room, seeing if you need any help, if you have any questions. So feel free to reach us out. And you'll be teleported to your breakout room in a minute. But does anyone have any doubts if we can clear them out before we enter? No? Okay, so I'm hungry as well because it's noon here and I haven't had lunch yet. So, yeah, that makes sense. Okay.
Can you share a mural link?
Your mural link will be in the breakout room.
It'll open directly there. So just give us a minute. We'll assign shortly.
Okay.
In the breakout, you're also going to find the tasks that Catarina outlined for us. So you're going to pick them one at a time and you'll have the link to the mural board there. And if you have any questions or you need support, there's a call for help button there in your breakout. And if you press, we can jump in and help you out.
Okay. Sending you now. See you soon.
Hi, how did we end up here?
Good question.
Surprise. Hi guys, I forgot to say to you that you would be doing step one first and then we're going to take you to the other step, so I'm sorry.
Okay.
Was everything running smoothly? Did you have enough time to do step one? Do you need any more time?
All good.
Okay. How it was? Did you get any characters? Twitter? Did you think of some? Yeah. Does anyone have any doubt? Go on, man.
Sorry, I was on mute. I am now. You can hear me now. Okay. We had Olaf. We have SpongeBob as well, and we had Baymax, the cuddly guy, the big cuddly guy who jumps around, and people from my team. Do you remember?
We had a couple of characters. We had Buttercup as one of them as well.
Where did those end up? Like, does that board exist somewhere?
Yes. Let me open that up for you. You are in group.
I think it's
right.
Two. Yeah, I think.
I have your board then. Thank you guys for taking the mic. Right, let me spotlight all of you. Everyone's on the board.
Yeah. SpongeBob makes a lot of sense to me. Nice. All of them are mostly yellow characters. So
is that a reference? No.
So Brandon visual assets are on point. That's nice.
Okay. We also have a meme.
I don't think Miro is opening for me, but I'm seeing on your Miro boards. Okay, can we go to the second step? Would that work out for you? Yeah. And Miro is saying warming up to me as well. I guess I'll close it. Next step, I'll be sharing my screen so you guys can see the results. Okay. And at the last step, the third step, I'm going to ask you to choose one person from your group to present the results to all of us. Okay, so we're going to be taking a look into your mural if you are all okay with that, and you will have 1 minute to present the results to us. So let's go to the second step. Second step will be yeah, we'll be going to focus on second step right now. And you can go to the second part of Mural. In the second part, the idea is for you guys to reflect on all of these characters you chose and finding character traits they share with the brand. So do as I did with Burger King. So for example, about SpongeBob, what they have in common with butter, and translate this to branding attributes. So, okay, fun, playfulness, and all of this kind of branding attributes. You will have 5 minutes to do this part, and then we will re-enter the main room so you can share any questions you have, and then we're going to be re-enter the breakout room in the next step, in third step, okay? All good? Seems good? Awesome. So you'll be teleported to the breakout again. You can do step 2 and 3 together if you like to. We don't need to re-enter the room. What do you think, guys? Yeah? Awesome.
Yeah, let's do it together, yeah.
Okay, so go ahead. Let's do it.
So we'll just extend, instead of 5 minutes, we'll give you how much time, Catarina, for step 2 and 3? 15?
12 minutes.
12 minutes. Okay, perfect. Then we will see you soon.
We'll see you soon. Thank you, guys.
We are having way too much fun in our room.
Same.
Welcome back, everyone. What are you guys laughing about?
We were just doing the last part of butter. And then we were saying that, yeah, something about memes.
Have you guys been able to finish it? Yeah. Everyone finished? Awesome. Who are going to be the representatives of the groups? Can you please, okay, raise your hand. Chanel, Lisa, who else?
Chris Lisa, and
the last one?
Yeah.
We have 3 groups. Lisa, which is your group?
Mine is group 3, Brian and Blossom.
Okay, Chanel, which is yours?
Gordana and Jigganathan. Sorry, I'll probably butcher it.
I think team 1 was the one who didn't decide yet.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm happy
with team 1 then.
Yeah, we were having too much fun as well. Unfortunately, we didn't decide, but I'm happy to put my neck on the line, and then maybe Maxine or others can jump in as well.
Okay, awesome, Seth. Okay, so can we start with team 4? So team 1 has time to prepare. Is that fine? Is that okay? I've been sharing your mural, so if you want to guide me. I'll be following you guys. So who's going to present team 4?
Cool. So I'm happy to. And then Gordana, jump in if I miss anything. But we had put down like Goofy, I think Salvador Dali, Elastigirl, Ant-Man, Eddie Murphy, Michael Jackson, and there's a bit of Banksy in there, and then a pop band, and there's sort of elements that we had pulled out. I'm trying to navigate. I'm so sorry.
That's fine.
Were things like creative, goofy, youthful, flexible, avant-garde. That element of performance with all of the interactive elements, things that jump out, music, that kind of thing. In terms of like, there's structure, but there's an element of fun, and there's like some humor that pops up every now and then. You're allowed to have fun with it. And then if you want to move down to the next section, apply. Yep. We sort of spoke about how better would communicate things around like being proactive on things like email and social media, communicating through other personalities, and showcasing use, like the showing use cases in action. Short bursts of communication is all about like short bursts, feedback, that kind of thing. Being playful and diverse and having those elements filtered throughout. And using informal language, we had a discussion about the types of tools we use because we're slightly older than, you know. How will the brand behave? It'll really be visible and part of the community, this element of community that sits around Butter. So evoking that youthful spirit, being quite different to Zoom, not so formal. Showcasing that smooth and interactive stuff that they do really well, and it'll be conversational because it's so informal. How will the brand present itself? Lots of color, lots of use of yellow, and lots of movement and sound.
Thank you, Chanel. That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Amazing team. Awesome. Thank you. Can we hear from group three now? You have 1 minute to present. So I'll be starting. That's fine. Okay.
So are you going to share our board? Yeah. Okay, cool. So we were basically looking at characters from cartoon characters because they're more playful and approachable. So we have Goofy, Quirky, Cute and Warm, Fuzzy, Winnie the Pooh. We have Energetic, Fun and Communicative. Didi, we have Cute, Friendly, but Powerful as well, Powerpuff Girl, but Blossom, I'm sorry, Bubbles, because she's the cutest. Then we obviously have SpongeBob, because it's visually very similar and fun. We have Tweety, because innocent looking, sassy, confident, but still playful and kind. Then we also have Augie from Augie and the Cockroaches, because he's very unique. Like, I don't know any other characters that would be with a cockroach. Anyways, for the attributes, we have fun, joyful, kind, quirky, playful, different, unexpected, because usually you wouldn't have something like this to be so playful. Also smooth, that's the name is amazing for that. New age and approachable, because it's very, new age to be informal. So that's why we put that. And then we also have the communication being easygoing, clear, because it's so easy to understand, and friendly, compassionate, relaxed, so there's no like formalness, because that's why it's relaxed. It behaves informal and very young, kind and approachable and energetic. And how is it presented visually? Is very bright, catchy, and warm. So that's what we have. Thank you.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, group. Everyone, so we are reaching our deadline to timing. So if you can stay a little longer to hear the rest of the teams, group two, please. Who's presenting?
our characters that we had, some of them were Baymax, the genie, SpongeBob, this Butter Man character, Buttercup from the Powerpuff Girls and the Ferocious Beasts, and Olaf and Clifford, and an Italian dog character. I forgot the name, but essentially all of these characters that we chose were characters that were funny and a little weird and out there, but also embraces community and people in general. And also characters that were fun to hug, because I feel like the Butter community just embraces all of its users itself. And if you could go to the next question.
Sure.
So some of the values that we've seen come from Butter primarily is the community itself. It's a one-stop shop and has a lot of features that you can integrate with other platforms and make so many fun different formats for yourself and really make every session unique to yourself and to whatever you're speaking about. It's very user-centered, and overall Butter is a place where organized chaos happens. Like, I feel like there's so much happening in Butter, but it's done intentionally and in a way that perfectly embodies everybody's ideas and hones in on whatever the mission is. And I really like that Butter is has this play-based learning aspect to it. One of the words that we talked about is gamification, which is making the experience fun and more interactive in a way that takes what you learn from a session and really keeps it memorable in your head and probably something you're going to talk about later in the day or a week from now. And the last question, the ways that Butter communicates, it's very quirky and friendly. I feel like with all the emojis and all of the meme content that I've seen from Butter, they're very much about humor and relating to their users and potential users and the community in general. One of the things that we talked about was Butter is very positive, has very positive confrontation aspects to it. So when you walk into a Butter session, you never really know what you're going into, even though you get that synopsis about what the meeting is going to be about. You never really know what you're going to do in a Butter meeting. And I feel like that's what's different than going into a Google Meets meeting or a Zoom meeting in a corporate sense. And lastly, Butter is very active in listening to their users' feedback. It's very inclusive and it's unexpected too. When Butter first started coming out, I started using Butter in its early stages, and they do take their feedback seriously. I think one of our team members mentioned that they were asked how a Butter session felt for them, and the CEO actually reached out to clarify that experience with them, and they were very felt very heard and felt that they were very taken care of because the CEO specifically reached out to them.
Thank you, Krisa. Guys, we're very late, so San, if you can share with us your results quickly. And I'll let you ask everyone, I know some of you have to leave, so if you can share your feedback in the chat with me, please, or connect with me on LinkedIn, I'll be very glad if you can share your feedbacks. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Yes. San?
We go through everything already, yes, right, with groups.
Yeah, we need group one, I guess.
Group one. Okay. We have one more volunteer. Or...
We have
a yeah. Well, can you, if you could share the screen, I can.
Yes.
Give you the. Yeah. I'll keep it brief. It's pretty much what everyone else said. So that's it.
So maybe just that, which might be new, Saad.
Yeah, I'll just touch on the bits that are new. Dynamic. Organized, structured was stuff that we talked about. Obviously, the Butter. So I think there's nothing new in the characters. Maybe we could go to step sure. two and three. Sure. I think we had a lot more. So what was really interesting is we came out with the bottom three there: structured, practical, experimental, which all connect to each other quite well. I thought this sandbox was a really great example of how, you know, we love the experiment nature of sandbox and allowing us to just, you know, be creative and just explore things, and then fun right bang in the middle that connects the glue to all of the interactivity and the social connection, as well as you know, the very sort of perhaps technical bits, if you like. And practical is a word we use quite a bit as well, in the sense of how, you know, it's a lot of learning by doing, and it's very hands-on, which we really like. And then on to step three, we thought that it's very welcoming. We did cheat a little bit, you know. We went to your website and we said, let's just steal your copy from
that
there.
That sounds familiar.
So effortlessly planned, you know, plan, run, recap, you know, this is what you talk about. Smoothly run and connect with other apps, clearly like we're doing with Mural, which is really, really great. We also plugged into the whole theme of, you know, playful. Someone said it really better than us, actually, about the youthful spirit and stuff like that. So we thought that was really great. Cool is how we think the brand behaves, which is really great. And then we talked about potentially being very colorful because of not just yellows, but lots of other colors, very modern text, very modern fonts, and, you know, things like that in terms of how you present yourself visually. So you can stay very relevant. So yeah, there's a little bit of maybe a different twist to some of the other groups, perhaps.
Thank you, San. Awesome. Guys, awesome work.
Amazing. It was like, it was cool to see the brand reflected back. And definitely thank you so much, everyone, for taking the time to be thorough and thoughtful. We'll share that back to the team. But as Catarina was saying, We'd also love, I know we're running 6 minutes into time, but if you have more time to share feedback about the session, that would be super lovely. So I'll open up a quick poll here. So as with all sandboxes, this is a session for us to experiment with format, techniques, different sort of structures, and we'd love to hear from you. What stood out the most for you in this session, and what do you think could be improved? If any of you would like to actually unmute or share more feedback to Catarina, that would be extra, extra welcome. And yeah, let's all give I'm going to open up the soundboard now as well. Let's all just take a moment to thank Catarina as well for leading us in this session.
Thank you, guys. Applause to you guys, because you did an awesome job.
Anyone wants to share feedback? Mimp seems to be gearing herself up.
God, why did you do that to me?
I could see you. And I know you.
I was typing. No, I had so much fun. I think the prompts were really fun to play with. And then that also made, like, I guess, like, I had a really nice team as well. And because we have such a nice prompt, we just ended up connecting so well together, even though we've never, like, really met. Yeah, so I had so much fun. I think the only comment I have is that if you could give examples next to the... I know you made, like, an example board, but it would be nice to sort of, like, have an example right then and there.
Awesome.
Yeah, kind of like how you did it anyways with, you know, like with each brand. Like, for instance, you'll say, oh, IBM has this tone of voice or that. But if you can sort of like give kind of an example of that, kind of like just next to it. So it's a little bit more like visually there. In the beginning, when we were trying to identify what we're supposed to do, we misunderstood those brands as something that we have to pick and choose to do. And then one of our teammates was like, no, we're not doing that. We're doing butter. And that was like the only reason why, like, oh, we came back to, okay, the prompt was supposed to do that. So yes, that is my feedback. If there's anything else, I'll let you know. I've reached out to you on LinkedIn already. So yes, I hope that's helpful.
Thank you so much.
I had so much fun.
That's awesome. I'm glad to hear. Thank you for the idea. Guys, does anyone have anything more to share? Feel free.
Just one point from me, if that's okay. I thought I really loved it. Did you call it accelerator because of how compact the exercise is, whereas you can get to a brand personality within three easy steps? Was that the idea?
Yeah, usually this takes like 3 hours. We had 45 minutes, so it was an accelerated version of it. That's why I call it.
Yeah, it was really great. I think it was really great. And I think I'll be using a similar approach to some of the stuff that I do, actually, which is really interesting. The only, again, I'm nitpicking here, but we spoke a lot about the difference between an attribute and a behavior and characteristic, and it may be just helpful to they overlap, right? They're obviously very connected, but it may just be helpful to clarify the difference and maybe anticipate upfront that people will, who are not experts in this, will actually make not a mistake, but that they will confuse behavior with characteristic, etc. And if you do it upfront and say this is an example of how they could either overlap and it's okay for them to connect or be the same thing, or maybe they're just synonyms of the same thing, that might be quite useful and put people's mind at ease, especially for people who are completely new to this. They might feel they're getting it wrong and they might slightly disengage. So if you want them to engage more, then maybe that might be a way forward, if it helps.
Thank you so much. That's very helpful. Awesome. Jessica, I think we can wrap that up. I'm going to close the poll. Guys, thank you so much. Thank you for the feedbacks. It was very valuable to me. You were my lab rat, as I said, so I'm very pleased on how it turned out. Thank you so much. I'm going to be taking all of those ideas and making this framework better. Feel free to reach me out on LinkedIn, and and so we can connect and discuss some ideas and create frameworks together. And thank you so much, Butter, for the opportunity, and Cesca and Andrea for being able to host this sandbox section. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. I'll put the link in the chat if you want to connect. And thank you. Enjoy the rest of your day, everyone.